Hello everyone. The topics that were discussed in the last class were configuration of customer and vendor master group, and we have seen how customer master data is created. So I will be practicing this and will share this with you. So let's begin. So type SPRO and then go to SAP reference IMG. So this is the path for creating customer accounts group. Then you will have to go to the financial accounting, then choose accounts receivable and payable, then customer accounts. Since we are creating for customer, then go to master data, and first preparation for creating customer master data, go to this part, and there you will see various options, and from here you have to define the accounts group with screen layout. Screen layout is nothing, you can control the field status from there. So just go to this, and now you will have to create different groups. So my company name is National, so I will be creating different groups, different customer accounts group for this. So my first account group is National Chemical Regular Customer. Okay, first group is NCRC Regular Customer for National. Okay, just do this part, select your 4-digit account group, whatever it is, then save it, define customer accounts group for my company National, save it. From here it has been saved. Now what to creating different group, you can either go back and then come back on this screen again, or you can just go from here next entry. So now create your next customer account group, National company foreign customer. You can create as many you want. So foreign customer for National, save it, and then create another customer accounts group, NCOC, that is one time customer. So just type over here your one time customer for National. And then please do not forget this part here. You will have to check mark this box because it is one time customer type account. So please don't forget this part. Check mark this and save it from here. Now we have created three customer types accounts group. Now go back, you will have to define the ranges for customer accounts group. So for this, come to this part, create ranges, and now just go to interval. Please keep in mind that your range should not be overlapped with the ranges which has been already defined here. Okay, so to make it more simple, you can select from this arrow part, okay, which is given the third one. It will give you the free intervals, so you can simply go and type your 2-digit representative key for this, but I am creating mine. So let's just see, 50, and it is this 2000000512. You can also create your own, and if you are finding problem, then you can choose that part where you will find the free interval ranges, and you can just type your numbers. Now we have typed, and there is no overlapping, and there is a column external, so it is for external assignment, but I am not assigning it externally here. It will be for internal assignment, so I am not tick mark this box, so I will not tick mark this box here. So just assign range, and yes, I will create three different ranges for my three customer types. So one range is for regular or local customer, another range is for foreign customer, and then my third range would be for one time customer. So okay, so just save this range from here, and then I will create another range, and again your range number should not be overlapped with any of these numbers. Please Otherwise, it will give you error if you even don't keep in mind. You won't be able to save it. So create your another range. Okay, so I will take the same. I have created 150, so I will take 51 and just increase these numbers to 0000 from 61 to maybe 70. Changes were saved, no overlapping. Thank you for this. Then my third range for one time customer. Okay, same 71 to maybe 80. Yeah, these many accounts will be enough for here. Okay, so in this part, one type account, I will take mark this external because I want to show you this part as well. So here I will assign these ranges externally. Okay, so just check mark that box over there, and now I will assign these ranges to the customer group. Type your account group NC RC. Okay, regular customer, just type your range, that is 50 in my case. And choose your another account group 51. Give me a minute. And then choose range for one time customer. It's 52. Here you will also see the X mark. It is X for external assignment. 52, it's here. See, now save it from here. Request generated. Assign number ranges to customer accounts group for national. Save it. 1 minute. Okay, so it has been saved. I have assigned my number ranges with the customer account group. Now in the second part, I will go to the business group, define their ranges, define business group, and assign those ranges with the business group. So our next step is to define business group and their ranges and assign those ranges with the business group. So let's see the path for business group. Type SPRO, go to SAP reference IMG, then go to cross application components, go to SAP business partner, then business partner, and there you will have to choose basic settings. And now go to this number ranges and grouping under basic settings, then go to this define number ranges. So select this intervals. So here also we have to keep in mind that no number ranges should be overlapped. So just create the number range as we have created under the business part, under the customer groups. And one more thing, here I am creating two ranges. Okay, one for both regular and foreign customer, and one for one type customer. So 50 representative I have created for regular and foreign customer, and 52 for my one type customer. So, and now I will define groupings and assign those ranges with the groups. So just choose any of your groups, 4-digit alphanumeric. So mine is NCB1, regular customer, and just type the same thing in the description. Regular customer for national. So NCB stands for National Company Business Group 1. You can choose any. So my second group is NCB2. It is for foreign customer. Foreign customer, and same thing over here, foreign customer for national. Just create your groups. And my third is NCP3. It is for one time customer. I'm customer for national. And now you will have to assign those ranges. So just select 50 for regular and again 50 for foreign customer. I have not defined another range, so same for both. And for one time customer I have created 52. Okay, and one more thing over here, you will have to tick mark this box external for external assignment. Okay, so do not forget this part. Define business group and assign ranges to business group. Save this data here. Okay, so till now we have completed two steps. In the first step, I have defined customer group, defined their ranges and assigned those ranges with the customer group. In the second step, I have defined business group, defined their ranges and assigned those ranges with the business group. In the third step, we need to link these two, customer and business group. So let's see how it is done. Go to SPRO. Okay, I am already on the same screen. Then go to this cross application components. Then master data synchronization. Then go to customer vendor integration CVI. And then now you have to select business partner settings. Settings for customer integration if you are preparing for customer master data. And go for vendor integration if you are doing the vendor master data. So just select this and set BP role category. Okay, just come down, go to this field assignment for customer integration and assign keys. Define number assignment for direction BP to customer. Here what does it mean from BP to customer? When we create master data, first BP number will create and then customer number is created. So that's the path. BP to customer, click this and new entries. Group I have created NCB1 and account NC regular customer. Okay, NCRC. Second group NCB2, NCFC, and third group NCB3. NCOC one time customer. Okay, same numbers and flexible group. So here flexible group we will tick mark here when we are assigning one group to many customer types, many customer account groups. But since I have created one to one, that is one business group to one customer, so I need not to do anything in these boxes. And the same numbers, when I created the number ranges in the customer account number ranges, for one time customer I have assigned external assignment. So for this, okay, so just mark this box and enter and then save it. Linked or assigned customer group with the business. Okay, so the configuration part has been done here for creation of customer master data. So let's go to the screen for creating customer master data. Create another screen, and here you will create on SAP Easy Access screen. Follow this path: financial accounting, then accounts receivable under this master records, and then go to this FT01. Click on this, select organization. Okay, first thing you have to select is 000 for general data, then go select create. Second thing, change the grouping from here. It will create a lot of chaos otherwise. So just choose your group. Mine is NCB1, regular customer for national. Now you will have to fill up all these basic details. Select company. I am choosing, okay, the intelligent investor, Investor India Limited. Investor India Limited. Then fill out all your basic details. B24A. Gajabad, India. B24 for Uttar Pradesh. And select here language. It is English. So this is the basic requirement as of now. Now just go to this. From here you can check whether there is any error or not. Just click this. So this entry is error free. Now you can save it from here. Entry has been saved, and see, this business partner number has been generated internally. Okay, and you can check my range over here. Which was 100. Just give me a minute. Yes, my range is starting from 100045. So one entry I have already created, so it was my second entry. That is why it is showing 100046. Now next step, what you have to do is just click this switch between display and change, select, and then from here select your FI, that is code for FLC U00. That's a cost. And one more thing, if okay, so select and then go to company code, again company code, delete this company, enter your company NCG1, that is my company. Okay, and tick mark this box, please do not forget this part. Adopt, select your reconciliation. Okay, since I have not created any reconciliation account for this company code, so first let me create the reconciliation. Go to FS. So I have created my reconciliation account, and from there I have selected this, and then saved it from here. So I have already done this. You will see same numbers will be generated since I have assigned this externally and also created on the same number while assigning those numbers. So you will also, you will have to do those configuration for this part. So this was about the customer groups and business partner groups, their linkage, and how we create the customer master data. I hope it will help you to understand it more. Thank you.